Chapter 30, Self-Reliance and Sense of Honor. Train every child to be self-reliant. So far as possible, every child should be trained to self-reliance. By calling to exercise the various faculties, he will learn where he is strongest and in what he is deficient. A wise instructor will give special attention to the development of the weaker traits that the child may form a well-balanced, harmonious character. Too much ease will develop weaklings. If parents, while they live, would assist their children to help themselves, it would be better than to leave them a large amount of debt. Children who are left to rely principally upon their own exertions make better men and women and are better fitted for practical life than those children who have depended upon their father's estate. The children left to depend upon their own resources generally prize their abilities, improve their privileges, and cultivate and direct their faculties to accomplish a purpose in life. They frequently develop characters of industry, frugality, and moral worth which lie at the foundation of success in the Christian life. Those children for whom parents do the most frequently feel under the least obligation toward them. Obstacles develop strength. It is obstacles that make men strong. It is not helps, but difficulties, conflicts, rebuffs that make men of moral sinew. Too much ease and avoiding responsibility have made weaklings and dwarfs of those who ought to be responsible men of moral power and strong spiritual muscle. From the earliest years, it is necessary to weave into the character principles of stern integrity that the youth may reach the highest standard of manhood and womanhood. They should ever keep the fact before their eyes that they have been bought with a price and should glorify God in their bodies and spirits which are His. The youth should seriously consider what shall be their purpose and life work and lay the foundation in such a way that their habits will be free from all taint of corruption. If they would stand in a position where they shall influence others, they must be self-reliant. Prepare children to meet problems bravely. Beyond the discipline of the home and the school, all have to meet the stern discipline of life. How to meet this wisely is a lesson that should be made plain to every child and to every youth. It is true that God loves us, that He is working for our happiness, and that if His law had always been obeyed, we should never have known suffering. It is no less true that in this world, as a result of sin, suffering, trouble, burdens come to every life. We may do the children and the youth a lifelong good by teaching them to meet bravely these troubles and burdens. While we should give them sympathy, let it never be such as to foster self-pity. What they need is that which stimulates and strengthens rather than weakens. They should be taught that this world is not a parade ground, but a battlefield. All are called to endure hardness as good soldiers. They are to be strong and quit themselves like men. Let them be taught that the true test of character is found in the willingness to bear burdens, to take the hard place, to do the work that needs to be done, though it bring no earthly recognition or reward. Strengthen the sense of honor. The wise educator, in dealing with his pupils, will seek to encourage confidence and to strengthen the sense of honor. Children and youth are benefited by being trusted. Many, even of the little children, have a high sense of honor, all desire to be treated with confidence and respect, and this is their right. They should not be led to feel that they cannot go out or come in without being watched. Suspicion demoralizes, producing the very evils it seeks to prevent. Lead the youth to feel that they are trusted, and there are few who will not seek to prove themselves worthy of the trust.